that's why. So here we are in Kashmir, a land of diversity, a land with many and many cultures, with traditions being followed more than 1,000 years. And one thing makes Kashmir even more special. It is the Pashmina shawl, also known as the Kashmiri wool or Kashmir wool. So sit back, relax, as we are going to take you into a journey through the process of this weaving of Pashmina, the history of Pashmina, while I am sipping on a cup of kahwa. A brief history of the Pashmina shawls. The Pashmina shawls are also known as Kashmiri wool, which originally got its name from the Persian word Pashma for wool. Pashmina is actually said to have originated from the neighboring country Nepal, where they had to look upon various factors favorable to make them warm. This is supposed to be the softest wool across the globe from the Himalayan region and the Tibetan plateau. The wool used in making of the Pashmina shawl is got from the Capra hircus, which is a kind of a goat, more popularly known as the Chiranga, and found at an altitude of 12,000 feet where temperature drops below minus 40 degrees centigrade. The skin of the goat with thin short hair is the most distinct feature of the goat, which is used in making of Pashmina and is best suited for cold climate. The Pashmina shawls were used during the Mahabharata. History also shows that Pashmina shawls were also used during the period of Mahabharata. A brief history of the royal admirers of Pashmina. It was in the early 16th century when the birthplace of the modern day Pashmina shawl or the Kashmiri wool took place. And the Mughal kings were swooned by the mere looks of it. Later, the aesthetics of this art spread more, and the French monarch Napoleon Bonaparte gifted his wife, Empress Josephine, a Pashmina shawl. She is believed to have owned a few hundred shawls in that time. In Iran, rulers wore as well as gifted Pashminas within their political practices. Here, in India, Maharaja Ranjit Singh decorated his court with hand-embroidered Pashmina shawls and fabric. The present scenario isn't too favorable for Kashmiri Pashmina. Yet, Kashmiri wool is even now considered the king of all fabrics, which makes it timeless and a worldwide heritage. The name Pashmina has been derived from the Persian word Pashma, meaning a weavable fiber, precisely wool. The wool used for making Pashmina comes from a special breed of Kashmiri goat found in the high altitude regions of the Himalayas. The 15th century ruler of Kashmir, Zain-ul-Abidin, is said to be the founder of the wool industry in Kashmir. However, the history of this shawl can be traced back to the 3rd century BC. Pashmina has been an integral part of the traditional wear for centuries. In earlier times, it was only worn by kings and queens and thus denoted royalty. The art of weaving Pashmina has been passed on as a legacy from generations to generations in the state of Kashmir. A good Pashmina shawl requires an expert hand for spinning, weaving, and creating embroidery. The grass that you have just eaten, oh goat, give us good pashmina. For the water you have just drunk, oh goat, give us good pashmina. Sit down on the grass and be still, oh goat, so that we can take out your pashmina. For the grass that you have just eaten, oh goat, give us good pashmina. Nice song, right?
This is a song that the Champa tribe recite as they comb the Pashm wool from their goats. Accordingly, apart from Orenburg, where the Orenburg shawl was knitted, the only other internationally known textile made from goat fleece before the 19th century, Pashm was produced in the commercial quantities only in the regions within reach of Kashmir, Ladakh and Western Tibet. However, only negligible amounts of Kashmir are produced outside Asia.
Western Tibet was controlled by a group of traders known as palace traders who received certain privileges such as an exemption from tax and homes in Ladakh for their service to the royal family. Their Kashmiri counterparts were known as Tibet Vekal. While most of the attention of these palace traders was focused on Western Tibet, there is another group of smaller traders who purchased their Pashmina from the eastern areas of Ladakh. These people were traders from Himachal Pradesh as well as farmers from village in lower and central Ladakh. Pashmina has long been a major factor in economic and political struggle throughout the region of Ladakh, Kashmir and Western Tibet. While Western Tibet was the main source for the supply of Pashmina, Kashmir was the home to a vast shawl producing industries, though it was known as the area within Ladakh. They also breed Pashmina goats. It was said that the finest wool came from Rodak and Nilgiri in Western Tibet. The trade in Pashmina in Ladakh followed certain guidelines that were outlined in the Treaty of Thingmosgang. Only Ladakhi traders were allowed into the Pashmina producing areas of Western Tibet to purchase the fiber, while the Kashmiri counterparts met them in Leh or Spituk. 80% of the world's Pashmina are exported to other countries. The remaining comes for various countries like Mongolia, Afghanistan, to name few. There are better companies to create product with artisan people than in Nepal. So most of the product are even imported and sold as if made locally. 99% of Pashmina are bought by the tourists or foreigners. Due to the current ongoing pandemic, most of the retail stores that are really on the tourist to buy are shut down. The last and the most worst part in the Pashmina is its selling price. There is no governing body to monitor the price. There are sellers selling the same products in different prices.
Differences between the Pashmina and the Kanchipuram silk. Criteria 1. Weaving. Pashmina. The Pashmina shawls are weaved by the artisans called wovers, and the process is called the woonin. The Kanchipuram silk. The Kanchipuram saris are woven using the mulberry silk thread, which is pure. Criteria number 2. The designs. Pashmina. The designs in the Pashmina shawl are usually floral patterns. There are a few other designs, but these are more dominating. The Kanchipuram silk. Designs and patterns in the Kanchipuram sarees were inspired by the nature, that is the birds, animals, leaves, or they were also inspired by the scriptures in the South Indian temples. Criteria number 3. The cost. Pashmina. The Pash wool comes from the Caprahircus goat or the Chantangi goat seen in the high altitudes of the Himalayan mountain. The wool of 3 whole goats is there in one Pashmina shawl. The cost can go from 15,000 INR up to 70,000 INR. Kanchipuram sarees. The Kanchipuram sarees vary widely in the cost depending upon the intricacy of work, colors, patterns, and the materials used, like sari, which is gold thread. Criteria number 4. Significance/usage. Pashmina. The pashminas can be used for gift wrapping, wedding, decor, and the benefit is that it can keep you warm and protected in the cold seasons. Kanchipuram silk. In the genuine Kanchipuram silk sari, the border and the body is woven separately and interlocked together. By doing this, even if the sari is torn, the border won't be detached. So this makes Kanchipuram sari different from the others. Criteria number 5. Real or real? Pashmina. To check whether the pashmina is real or fake, check the smell of the burnt fabric and check the ashes with your fingers carefully. If you get a burnt hair smell and the ashes are powdery, then it is likely to be the real pashmina. Kanchipuram silk. The burning fabric should also smell like burning hair because both of them have a fibrous protein. In the case of silk, it's called fibroin, and for hair, it's keratin. A synthetic fiber will smell like burning plastic and it will drip and form black balls of residue, and it will cause black smoke.
Sometimes you will never know the true value of something until it becomes a memory. Hari Om, this is Sai Vaishnavi here to say about the geographical factors which favor in the production of Pashmina shawls. Pashmina shawls are made using the raw unspun wool of Chantangi goats. The reason for it to be so popular all over the world is that they are very light and extremely warm. The wool used to make pashmina is made from the wool of specially breeded sheep. Now, let's see about the geographical conditions required for the production of wool which is used for making the pashmina. Starting in the earliest times, wool has been used to make textiles in the old world, and many countries continue these ancient traditions in contemporary handicraft industry such as carpets and rugs. Wool is thus a fairly important commodity in world trade. Synthetic fibers have now been evolved which reproduce or better the main qualities of wool. As a result, the world wool production has tended to stagnate in recent years. Wool needs favorable climatic condition like dry climate. The northern hemisphere are unsuitable for growing wool, whereas
the southern hemisphere leads in wool production. The rather dry climate of interior Australia and South Africa are ideal for wool production. As the land in the drier regions cannot be used for agriculture, sheep farming is the most often economic use of land in drier regions.
Process and evolution of Pashmina. The procedure of making handloom Pashmina includes three categories: spinning, weaving and dyeing. Throughout the winter season, after shearing it in the summer, the inner wool of the goat regrows and gets prepared for the extraction in the coming spring season. Every year, the wool is collected and undergoes the spinning process done by hand. It starts with shearing the wool, cleaning it from sweat and dirt, dyeing it into colors, spinning fibers into yarns, and then weaving the yarns to make the final fabric. As the pashmina is highly delicate, they should be woven by hand in a charkha or in hand looms. The traditional method was very time-consuming and tedious. The wastage caused by the hand looms is now reduced due to power looms. Handmade pashmina is 20 times more durable than the machine-made ones. The process mostly hasn't evolved much to maintain its purest form. After weaving, they are soaked in a rice and water mixture to revive its softness. But now, it's done with soap and water, which causes it to pill faster. Kashmir Pashmina is not just the wool obtained from the Pashmina goat. Rather, it is a unique preparation with 20 processes specific only to Kashmir to prepare the final Pashmina fabric. The wool obtained is called thumb in Kashmiri. Sozri is one of the most sophisticated forms of needle embroidery in the world. This extremely fine, delicate and artistic needlework is only practiced in Kashmir and has no parallels anywhere else. The weaving is done using the 15th century hand looms.
Wow, that was an amazing journey. From the history to the weaving process, from the demand and trade to the comparisons with other fibers. Also, we learned about how the geographical factors play an important role in the Pashmina shawls. In this beautiful journey, we not only learned about the weaving process or the history of the Pashmina, we also learn about our Indian culture, how we should respect it and how we should preserve it. Even now, Pashmina shawls are woven using the hand looms of the 15th century to attain its purest form. Why is it done? To preserve our culture. So next time you visit any of the states in India, any city, any state, make sure you learn about the local factors, the local traditions, so that we can get a wider spread of knowledge of our country. Hari Om and thank you. This is the class 8A signing off.